أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين، نبينا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري، واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا، اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا، وانفع بما علمتنا وزدنا علما. قال الله تعالى: يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. وقال تعالى: ومن آياته خلق السماوات والأرض واختلاف ألسنتكم وألوانكم، إن في ذلك لآيات للعالمين. صدق الله العظيم. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: إن الله تعالى لا ينظر إلى صوركم وأموالكم، ولكن ينظر إلى قلوبكم وأعمالكم. صدق الله مولانا العظيم، وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم، ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. My dear respected brothers and elders, mothers and sisters, all praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our creator, sustainer, nourisher and provider, the originator of the heavens and the earth, the king of all kings, the one that we worship, the one that we perform salatu 5 times a day. All praise is due to Allah, and abundant salawat and salam upon our beloved Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers and elders, mothers and sisters, as a believer in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we strive to please Allah. We are the creation of Allah. Allah is the creator. And being the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have an obligation. And that obligation is to please the creator, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And we learn how to please our creator, and we learn how to develop the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through following the footsteps of our beloved Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As Allah Azza wa Jal very beautifully mentions in the Quran, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونَ. That if you truly love Allah, then follow in the footsteps of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And by following the footsteps of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يُحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهِ. Allah will love you. وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive all of your sins. And that's what we want. We want to attain the love of Allah. We want to make Allah happy. And in order to make Allah happy, we need to sacrifice. And we need to humble ourselves. Because when we go against the words of Allah and the sunnah tariqah, the way of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that in itself is a form of arrogance. Because when it comes to culture, does Islam cater for culture? Yes. But if the culture goes contrary to the teachings of Islam, then culture has to say bye-bye. If the custom goes against the sunnah of our beloved Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, And the establishment of the Sharia, the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is when we have to put the culture aside, if the culture goes against the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Islam is not based upon what we think is right. Islam is based upon the words of Allah and the words of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his lifestyle. And if we imitate our Prophet, if we follow our Prophet in every facet of life, we can never go wrong. We can never go wrong. My dear respected brothers and elders, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was sent لِيُخْرِجَ النَّاسَ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ. He was sent to take mankind out of darkness to light. مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent, he was sent as rahmatul lil alameen, a mercy to the worlds. And the Prophet of Allah, he was sent at a time where the Arabs, as Allah Azza wa Jal says, لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ عَزِيزٌ عَلَيْهِ مَا عَنِتُّمْ حَرِيصٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. The Prophet of Allah, at that time, he was sent to the Arabs. He was sent amongst the Arabs. And at that time, it was a time of jahiliyyah, of ignorance, where people would bury their own daughters alive. They had no respect for women folk. They had no ethics. They had no understanding of how to be a human being. But our beloved Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, through his conduct, and that is why the Prophet of Allah, what did he say? إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. He says, I have been sent to perfect man's character. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Arabs at that time, subhanallah, they were not humans. They would bury their children alive. They had no respect for their parents. They were totally off track. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the greatest human being, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to show them the lights. To show them the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to portray the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is kalamullah. My dear brothers and elders, we need to take a step back. And we need to understand, a lot of the times we pose the question, brother, where you come from? And we take so much pride in our lineage. We take so much pride in where we come from. But what we need to understand is, regardless of where we come from, the bottom line is that we are the progeny of Adam alayhi salam. It does not matter. And that is why in today's khutbah, I'm going to be blunt and I'm going to say it as it is. And unfortunately, one of the most biggest diseases in our community all over the world, and every one of us, we are guilty in some portion of our life, and that is we are racist. It's racism. Racism. I am better than you. I am more superior than you. And this took place before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us. Because when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose to create or make a vicegerent on this earth, وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose to make a vicegerent, a khalifa on this earth, Shaytan, Azazil, Iblis, he opposed it. He was not happy. Why? He showed arrogance. He said, أَنَا خَيْرٌ مِّنْ. I am better than. So this trend of racism, looking down upon others, is of the footsteps and the plot of Shaytan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam and Hawa. And regardless, at the end of the day, that is how we are connected. We are from the progeny of Adam and Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. We are one. And we need to learn, we need to return back to our roots. And we need to understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created Adam. And we are from the limbs of Adam. We are from the progeny of Adam. And Adam alayhi salam, he was created from what? He was created from dust. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَكُمْ مِنْ تُرَابٍ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created me and you. We are from turab. But unfortunately, we live in a time where we find racism on all levels. We look down upon people with darker skin. This is haram. This is racism. We look at all aspects of life. We call ourselves a Muslim. And we look down upon other races. We look down upon different cultures. We look down upon various ethnicities. My dear brothers and sisters, Islam came to destroy all forms of racism. Racism in Islam is haram. It is haram. And in the sight of Allah, me and you, regardless of our race, regardless of what language we speak, regardless of the color of our skin, wallahi, we are all equal in the eyes of Allah. And if you are to show arrogance or think that you have more preference over any other human being, then you have adopted the way of shaitan. You have adopted the way of shaitan, because shaitan, what did he say? I am better. And if you think for a moment that your wealth and the color of your skin will grant you Jannah before someone else, you have got it wrong. We need to understand why has Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created, this is the system of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine each and every human being had the same color skin. Imagine we all had the same color skin and we all had the same hair. This life would be so boring. True. But wallahi, when we look at the system of Allah, we look at the beauty. MashaAllah, we have brothers that have dark skin. They're so beautiful. We have brothers that have, you know, various colors, shades of skin. It goes lighter. Alhamdulillah. When we look at this, it increases us in iman. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about this various colors of skins and the various languages, yani, all of this is the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you look down upon another race, you are looking down upon the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ خَلْقُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. From the signs of Allah is that He has created the heavens and the earth. وَاخْتِلَافُ أَلْسِنَتِكُمْ وَأَلْوَانِكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created the various languages and the different colors of skin. Allahu Akbar. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِلْعَالِمِينَ. And in that is a sign for the people of knowledge. If you have a connection with Allah, you will understand that when you look at your brother, you don't look down upon them. Be honest with yourself. Wallahi, we are a very racist nation. We are very quick to look down upon other people with different skin colors. And wallahi, this is the trait of jahiliyyah. And this also took place in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But do you want to know something? Wallahi, Islam would not be the same if it was not for the African people. Islam would not be Islam if it was not for the amazing contribution of the amazing African people. When the Sahaba radiyallahu anhum ajma'een were going through so much torture, the Quraysh, they were abusing them, they were battering them, they were beating them up. They put the Sahaba through so much difficulties. In the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Quraysh, the Prophet's own people went against our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent revelation to our beloved Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to make hijrah, to go to where? To where? An African country where there is a just ruler. A just ruler, subhanallah. King Najashi, who is just. And he will understand your situation. And he will allow you to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This was revelation from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And these beautiful, dark-skinned people. Because where Abyssinia was situated was very close to Ethiopia. And of course they were dark-skinned people. But they were amazing people. They had an amazing ruler. And it was through them that they were able to practice Islam. Have we forgotten that, subhanAllah? Who was the first muadhin of Islam? We are very quick to put names of our masjids, Masjid Bilal. But how much do we get these beautiful African people involved in our committees, in our societies? But unfortunately, we live in a time, subhanAllah, we think that we are better than someone else. Allahu Akbar. Look at your own homes. Look at your life. Did you ever go out of your way to invite someone from a different background? When you had a wedding invitation, who did you invite? Or if you're from a rich background, you only invite the rich. What about that person? Oh, I will never invite him to my house. Astaghfirullah, who are you? Who do you think you are? Do you think that you are better than Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam? Is this what Islam teaches us? To look down upon other people that have different skin color? La, this is not Islam. This is the trait of the Jahiliyyah, a very famous incident in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. When Abu Dharr, he said to Bilal, that, oh son, you're a son of a black woman. Ya Ibn Sauda. This hurt Bilal radiallahu anhu. He went to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam complaining that Abu Dharr, he addressed me in such a disrespectful manner. He called me, oh, son of a black woman. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, immediately he called him. He said, oh Abu Dharr, did you say this? He says, by Allah, oh Messenger of Allah, yes, I have said this. The Prophet of Allah became so angry. And he says, by Allah, you have the traits of Jahiliyyah within yourself, O Abu Dharr. He says, by Allah, if that is the case, then I am also the son of a black woman. Because who was the lady that breastfed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam? She was an African woman. Allahu Akbar, takbir.
Allahu Akbar.
This is to show the beauty of Islam. The Prophet of Allah says, anyone who has the traits of Jahiliyyah, they will be thrown into the fire of Jahannam. The Sahaba said, Ya Rasulullah, wa in sama wa in salla, what if we pray salah and we fast during the month of Ramadan? The Prophet of Allah says, even if they pray and they fast during the month of Ramadan, if they are to have this racism, this hatred within their hearts, to say that I am better than you, if they have these traits, because if you are racist, that means you also have the traits of Jahiliyyah within your life. The Prophet of Allah said, even if a person makes salah and he fasts during the month of Ramadan, they will be thrown into the fire of Jahannam. How can we call ourselves a Muslim when we look down upon a person with a different color skin? In actual fact, if you are to see someone with a different color skin, you as a Muslim, we need to go out of our way and even show these brothers more respect. We must show them more love to make them feel special. Because you know what? The Sahaba that were close to Rasulullah, and I'm sorry to say I use South Africa because I studied there for 12 years. Wallahi, the racism that I saw, unbelievable, shocking, shocking. And this is not Islam. It's not Islam. You know, I was born in Australia, subhanAllah, in Perth. One of the beauty things of this country, we don't care about the color of your skin, my friend. It means nothing. It means nothing. All my friends, I had friends from all facets of life. At the end of the day, there is only one title for all of us. We are Muslim. Regardless of the color of your skin, your hair, regardless of your ethnicity, it means nothing in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And hence the reason why the Prophet of Allah said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى لَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَى صُوَرِكُمْ وَأَمْوَالِكُمْ. Allah does not look at what your bank balance is. Don't think that you're a rich man, you're going to Jannah first. No, the poor will go Jannah first. Allah does not look at what color is your skin, what language you speak, how rich you are. وَلَكِي يَنْظُرُ إِلَى قُلُوبِكُمْ. But Allah looks at your heart. Allah looks at your heart and your a'mal, that is what counts in the sight of Allah. Don't look down upon any Muslim. You look down upon that person, he could have stronger iman than you and I. He could enter Jannah before me and you. Never look down upon any human being. Because we are all the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When it comes to marriage, we become the most racist. He has to be Arab. He has to be Indian. The girl comes to the father. We make it so hard. Oh no, he's not Arab. He's not Indian. He's not Asian. No. He's not African. No. It has to be out. Where has this come from? The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, if a person approaches you for his daughter, for marriage, if they have good akhlaq and they have deen, you are obliged to let your daughter go. If your daughter is happy and she wants to get married and these two qualities are found, bismillah. But in today's time, we have become so racist. We have made it so hard for our brothers and our sisters to get married. And we all know what we are talking about. And we are all guilty of it. Oh, my husband, my son has to get married to my tribe. Even within India, there's conflict. From this tribe, he has to be or either Memon or Gujarati, or if he's from this Arab clan or that Arab clan. Where is this in Islam? Islam came to destroy all of this. That we are all one. When you stand next to your brother in Salah, Salah should unite our hearts. Doesn't matter. Sometimes, wallahi, I was Imam of Kirby for 7.5 years. I saw people, dodging people, and they greet only the people of their own ethnicity. This is haram. You call yourself a Muslim, and you only want to greet the people on your level. What type of Muslim have we become? This is not Islam, my dear brothers and elders. We need to go back to our Quran and the Sunnah teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We are one ummah and we need to mean it. Never look down upon a person. Look at this ayah. Allah, you know, when we have nikah, we always call the huffaz to read this ayah. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً. From the signs of Allah, we have created the male and the female to dwell in happiness and love. Allah mentions this ayah. And then Allah mentions an ayah after that. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَكُمْ مِنْ تُرَابٍ. From the signs of Allah, we have created you from dust. We have all come from the dust, from earth. And between these two ayat, Allah Azza wa Jal mentions this ayah. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ خَلْقُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافُ أَلْسِنَتِكُمْ وَأَلْوَانِكُمْ. From the signs of Allah, Allah has created the heavens and the earth, the different nationalities and languages, the colors of skin. And these are the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why are we racist? Why are we putting barriers? Wallahi, if we are to become racist on this level, we will be taken into account by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of Qiyamah. The Prophet of Allah, I end off. The Prophet of Allah, in his last sermon, our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in his final sermon, and this sermon was not only for those people, it was for humanity at large until the day of Qiyamah. What did the Prophet of Allah say? لا فضل للعربي على العجمي ولا للعجمي على العربي إلا بالتقوى. There is no preference of an Arab over a non-Arab, or an Arab, a non-Arab over an Arab, except in taqwa, in Allah consciousness. Allah does not judge us by how we look, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will judge us by our connection with Him, tabaraka wa ta'ala. And by Allah, we will never be successful as Muslims for as long as racism exists within our hearts. Racism will destroy our community. No country, no community can be successful with racism. The next time you walk into the masjid, greet everyone. Show love and respect to every single one of them. Why? Because we are all brothers in Islam. Because we are all the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah forgive us. May Allah unite our hearts, the true unity. And may Allah azza wa jal remove this evil quality of racism from our hearts. And if we ever have been racist in the past, may Allah forgive us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to move forward as one ummah. May Allah break down these shackles and plots of shaitan and racism. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unite the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.